Steve, you're up for this, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah, totally.
The place is going to be empty. We just need people to sit up and listen. This is the big one. Yeah. The chance we've all been waiting for.
We've got a problem.
An engagement party?
Are you serious? Why am I only finding out about this now? And what are you wearing? Is he telling you how to dress now?
Oh, get lost, Steve!
I hope our Hannah's not coming to this circus.
Leela's got her.
Are you joking? I'm a dad. She should be with me.
You're not going anywhere near her. I've told you, until you move out of that house and get away from them racists, you won't have nothing to do with
them. Oh, but it's okay for her to hang around that lot and listen to the rubbish.
Rubbish?
Don't, Sammy.
What, do you think I sit there every night and try and teach her about this strange and mysterious religion you're so scared of?
Yeah, I do. You know what? I'm fighting this. Because you can't stop me from seeing me, kid. So I'm going to go to the courts and I'm going to get access. One last thing. Don't even think about doing anything stupid. Like changing her surname to Malik.
Why not?
Just leave it.
Because it starts with a name, and before you know it, she's going to be speaking in a foreign language, he's going to try and marry her off to some old guy she's never even met.
You're absolutely right, Steve. You know, she'll be on a plane to India quicker than you can say tikka masala. Oh, and by the way, she is never celebrating Christmas ever again.
Just cut it out.
No, what? That's what morons like him think, isn't it? You know, you say you want to be a father, yet you are too stupid to see through a racial stereotype.
Hey. Got your text? Have you an eye?
No. We're being watched. A woman in the village. Undercover old Bill, it has to be. I can smell him a mile off. The job's off. We stand down.
What?
No way, come on. If they know about us, they could know about the community centre. I've got the paper trail out of the house, the blueprints, the photos, everything.
We've been planning this for ages.
Well, we've been compromised. Who did you get that device from?
People I trust.
Are you sure about that?
Of course he is. It's good to go, and so are we.
Johnny, just leave it
now. No, listen. We were supposed to go for direct action, taking a stand.
That's what you promised. You can do nothing from a prison cell.
Prison cell? Listen to me.
I don't care about the risks. Let me prove myself to you. I'll do this on my own if I have to.
Nothing.
You will do nothing until I tell you to. You understand? Now that's an order.
Oh, wake up, Steve. Look at who you're living with. Look at what they stand for.
I didn't want this. Oh,
but you got it, didn't you? People are hurt. Lives have been devastated. And it's not your fault.
Look, cat, baby.
It can't be because they promised me that everything was going to be okay. You know, I just wanted people to start taking me seriously. Yeah, to listen to the things that I care about. I'm not into violence. I just wanted some respect. And for people to understand how I see the world, that is wrong. Yeah, and I tried to stop it. I did.
You had your chance, Steve. A long time ago, but you chose a life of hatred. Look what's happened. You know, you say you didn't want any of this, but you're part of an organisation with extreme views. You hate me. You hate my family. You hate my religion. I just don't understand why.
I don't want to talk about it.
What is it about Islam that scares you so much? Go on.
Do you seriously want me to sit here and go through all the laws that Muslims have and all the changes that they want to make to Britain?
Do me a favour. You think Sharia law's gonna take over?
Oh, yeah, it could. But they've got all these secret councils that they won't even admit exist.
I'm a lawyer, Steve, okay? I think I know if that was a real threat, and it's not.
Yes, it is. They've even got no-go areas in cities. That's proven.
Where? Huh? Where can't you go? And what makes them no-go areas?
The violence. And all the hatred. They can't stand gays.
I know loads of Muslims in my own family who support gay rights.
And I know loads that stand outside school gates and say we can't teach kids about homosexuality.
That's an extreme view, and I'm sorry to break it to you. It's not exclusive to Islam. You know, people can twist and interpret any religion to support their bigoted opinions.
It's a fact, Sammy. I've read the articles, I've seen the videos online.
Okay. And did you fact-check them, did you? Or did you just assume, oh, it must be true because your racist mate stuck it on his homepage?
I know that these things happen.
Oh, come on, Steve. No, whoever spat in your face. You're a gay father. You've been married. No Muslim has ever tried to stop you living their life, have they?
No, not yet.
No, not ever. You know, I don't think you started to hate Islam until Johnny and Stuart came into your life.
No, Johnny and Stuart opened my eyes to what's really going on in the world.
Nah, they found an angry young man who'd lost his way in life and they leapt on you.
Yes, and I had every right to be angry.
You were angry about Tegan. Okay, you blame Mizpah for her death. You obviously still do.
I don't care what the hospital tells me or what anybody says. I know that woman made a mistake. I know she did.
Okay, even if that's true, tell me, did it have anything to do with the fact that she's a Muslim? In many ways, I don't even blame you. You were vulnerable, and they knew that. They're a bunch of vultures who got inside your head and shoved hatred down your throat. You know, and they are so practiced, you didn't stand a chance. And they made you believe that all of that pain you felt was about a religion and a culture that was different to yours. It wasn't. It was about a doctor treating a woman who was involved in a terrible accident, that's all. You know, I don't think you hate Muslims. Nah, not really. I think you're a terrified boy who's still grieving for his little sister. You were groomed, Steve. This whole thing is so much bigger than you. They're a machine, and this is how they operate. They find lost souls just like you, have no one else to turn to, and they recruit them as foot soldiers in their made-up war. That's you, Steve.
Yep.
They targeted you deliberately. Give meaning to your life, got you back on your feet, so you felt grateful for their support. And all that time they were drip feeding you lies. They are not your friends, Dee. They used you. They taught you hate. And now look. You're standing in the wreckage of a fight you didn't need to have.
Yeah, I'm looking for Johnny back.
I don't want you in here. I don't want you torturing me. I have a right to say, treat me. So get me a British nurse, will you?
I am a British nurse.
Seen him? Places full of them, mate. Vermin.
Vermin. Are you for real? Mizpah's just saved your life.
Shut up. She put a towel on me leg. Change is nothing.
Are you that far gone?
You really hate them that much that you was pushing it away. Do you understand what could have happened to you, Johnny?
Read my lips, Dee. I don't care. I've got principles, beliefs.
How have I gone from making a few memes to this?
Cowards are behind keyboards, Dee.
Cowards? And what you did? What you were planning to do to all those people in the loft. Me friends. Me family, people that I've known for absolute years. Who does that? What do you even call yourself?
I am a warrior, Steve, and you are too. You're just scared because it went wrong.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not. Do you know that I spoke to Sammy?
And you told me that you and Stuart only picked on me because I'm vulnerable. And that you've been using me. Hmm? And saying all this stuff to me. Just to get into my head so it's all mashed up.
What are you talking to him for?
I am not on board with any of this. Hurting people. That's not who I am. And that is not who I want to be. And I might have agreed with some of the stuff that you and Stuart were saying, but I don't think... I don't even know what to believe anymore. So is Sammy right? Have you been grooming me?
I thought we were a brotherhood, Steve. One unified purpose.
No. No, you've just been telling me who to hate.
Are you messing? I am not having this. I don't even know what grooming is. I cannot believe you've let that manic lad inside your head.
Oh, man, I've let you get inside my head.
Oh, have you? And when was that? When I was getting you a job and I was keeping you sober? Yeah, when I was taking you to the footy or putting a roof over your head?
You can't throw that on me.
Can I? Why not? I'll tell you why you can. Because I gave you a life.
But isn't that all part of the plan?
What?
You make me feel like I owe you something. I looked up to you. I thought that I'd be nothing without you. But you know what? Where's all my friends and family? I've turned my back on all of them for you.
You're one of us, Steve. We're your friends and family. I haven't told you a lie at all. I've told you the truth. The country is under threat, and you know it is.
Maybe. No, I'll tell you the truth.
Go ahead.
When you and Stuart start saying all these things, I nod my head and I go along with it, really. And I trust what you're saying's right because you're smarter than me.
Do you know what this sounds like to me? Things got real today and now you've bottled it. Yeah, I get serious, I step it up a level, and all of a sudden you've been groomed.
It's not like that.
You're getting your story straight for the busies like a proper little wuss. Poor Steve, poor me. It's not my fault. All the nasty men made me do it.
Yeah, well, maybe you did.
Oh, get here with listen to me.
Enough!
If anybody should be angry, it's me. Can you walk?
Yeah. I guess so, yeah. But the doctor said that he wants to keep an eye on me.
Now, you both listen to me. If we don't get our story straight by the time the old Bill catch up with us, we're all looking at 25 years in prison. Right, we're gonna have to talk to the police at some point. If it makes sense, we can stay here while we talk.
This was never meant to happen. I gave you all an order. If anybody disobeys me again, you'll have more than a smack in the mouth to worry about. Do you understand? Yeah. Now, from now on, you listen and you do exactly as I tell you. Otherwise, the police, they will be the least of your worries.
You all right, then? You back on board with this, or what?
I don't know. I can't think straight. It doesn't feel real, any of this. But you need to see a doctor for your injuries. You just walked out of hospital.
Listen to me, there's no time for that, OK? Stuart wants a public arrest outside the tea house because it makes for good video, gets more people on our side.
Who even thinks like that?
Stay!
Wait. Get rid of him.
Not right now, I'll talk to you later. Just leave me alone!
Please tell me this explosion had nothing to do with you. Someone could have died.
You don't understand.
Have you lost your mind?
He's asked you to leave, ladies.
Better do as he says.
No. Do you want this is your fault? You have done this to my brother. You're a bunch of animals!
Oh, police, get on the floor! Get down now! Get your hands behind your back!
Police, get down! Get down! Get down! Get down!
Exactly where you are. Can you tell us what you know about the incident that took place this afternoon at 65 Chrysalton Terrace?
No comment.
Were you in the house at the time of the incident?
No comment.
Did you witness the incident?
No comments.
No comment.
No comment.
You have been arrested on charges of terrorist activity. How does that make you feel?
No comments.
No comment.
No comment.
Why are you crying?
No comment.
Talk to me, Stephen. I've looked at your record. You've got no previous for terror-related offences. From what I can see, you've known these guys for less than a year. You're a dad with three young kids. How did you end up in this situation? I want to help you. I want to believe you're different, but you have to be brave enough to break away from these people. If you're scared, I can protect you. If you're confused, I can give you clarity. But you have to tell me what you know. Trust me.
No comment.
Do you have anything at all that you'd like to say?
I'll tell you everything. I like to think of us as a family.
A family that plans sophisticated attacks on innocent targets.
A family that likes to help each other out. That's prepared to get together on a Sunday afternoon, celebrate our culture, get the barbecue going, bouncy castle for the kids, community events that I'm proud to be a part of. But you see, the thing with families is, you know, every now and again, you'll realise that you've got a rotten apple. What happened today has left me utterly shaken. But the person responsible for this acted entirely on their own. They sourced all the materials. They put the plan together without consulting anyone.
And how do you know this?
He told me. This afternoon. And I'm devastated.
I bet you are.
He's not a bad lad, you see. Not really. But you know the type? Didn't succeed at school. Not got much going for him. I'm just relieved no one died today.
So, this rotten apple, has he got a name?
I didn't think that you'd show up.
Neither did I. After the beating you gave me.
First few days after I left Budapest, I was lying on a hospital bed with a couple broken ribs and shattered jaw thanks to you. It's okay, Steve. I understand why you did it. I've been there. I know how they egg you on, press you into doing their dirty work. I've done things myself I'm not proud of.
No, I didn't want to do it. It was Stuart. He didn't give me a choice.
You always have a choice. No, I'm not having a go, but you need to understand you're not innocent in all of this.
You know, I thought I was fighting on the right side. I didn't want any of this. I didn't want this. And then when I found out how far they were willing to go, that they were planning on hurting people, I tried to stop it.
Are you sure you're not just saying this now because you're worried you'll face charges?
No. I tried to leave them, but they threatened me. That's why I've got in touch with you. Because I'm trapped.
Look, I can help you, but you need to put your trust in me.
Whatever it takes, I have to get out.
What's this?
You shocked me! This is Officer Turley from Prevent.
Prevent? Yeah, we've met.
You'll help with the transition once you leave.
We can support you. And there are organisations out there that can help you find things like accommodation and financial aid.
Thank you. That's all I want. Just somewhere new to start off with my kids. I need to get away from those maniacs.
Ideally, we want you out as soon as possible. But it has to be safe, which may take some time.
What's it? You see, saying I've got to go back there and carry on as normal?
Just in the short term, that's what we'd recommend.
What? No, wait, is this a joke? I thought you were supposed to be helping me. I've got to get out today.
There are procedures that we need to follow, and you'll need counselling to determine why you turned to extremism in the first place.
I am not a criminal. I'm just a normal bloke. It's too dangerous for me to go back. These people, they know my family, they know my kids.
You can't do this on your own. What if you get caught?
Well, I'm willing to take the risk. Because if I stay, I'm worried what they'll make me do. I don't want to hurt anybody else.
If you want to leave today, I will help you.
Yeah. Thank you. Are you going to save my life?
Somewhere.
I'm just taking my dirty washing to Leela's.
Haven't you already been round here once today?
Yeah. But we've sorted things out. Said she's gonna help me out now, seeing as we're homeless.
Hey, whoa.
You're lying. You're doing a runner. You answered out the moment the things got heavy.
That was just Sammy. Trying to get into my head. I was a little bit scared. But you know what I'm like? I wouldn't last 5 minutes back inside, would I?
That's why we did you a favour. Let Dave take the rap. Or should I let you go down for this?
You have to believe me. I'm so loyal to you two. You guys are my family now, aren't you? I haven't got anybody else.
Aren't you going to answer that?
I can just bring them back in a second.
Wait, is it? Give me...
Let go. Let go.
Jess, what's taking so long?
Jed, you're in league with that rat who tried to build a case against us. Are you messing?
You were warned.
I get it. No, please. I'm a single dad. It was just a mistake, please. No, Johnny, don't.